So we now know, Johnny, the lineup of this year's Molloy Environmental Systems Offaly Senior Hurling Championship Final. Kilcormac Killoughey got over Belmont yesterday. Belmont with a late rally in that game, but a county semi-final here between St. Rynagh and Boran. Just down that home straight, Rynagh took control.
Yeah, Rynagh pulled out all the stops, showed all their experience when it really mattered. You could sense from early on, okay, Boar seemed to have the upper hand in a lot of areas on the field, but when they regrouped for the water break after half-time, you could sense from that period on that Rynagh really took over that game. And, they were hunting in packs, they were chasing down Boar, they didn't give them time on the ball, and when they were playing it in, actually, probably physically, they were overpowered them as well in crucial positions on the field. And they're going to go hard for the final, obviously, as the current champions.
The last 10 or 12 years, a lot of county finals have been decided by St. Rynagh and Kilcormac Killoughey. They know each other inside out. Rynagh, the current county champions under Ken Hogan, looking to do two in a row, which they found it hard to do. A lot of teams find it hard to do back-to-back in Offaly, a competitive championship. And you know, Kilcormac Killoughey be maybe quietly confident under their new manager Tom Murphy that they've introduced a bit of talent and could be the favourites for the county final.
Yeah, I suppose Rynagh's probably been the reigning champions, probably will go in possibly as the slight favourites, but there won't be much between them. As I said, I was watching the game yesterday with KK, and you know, they've injected a nice little bit of youth and a bit of freshness into their team, and also to have all those experienced guys and lads on the line as well. So both teams, actually, even St. Rynagh's have introduced a few new guys in there this year. You know, Aaron Kinney's in there and Luke O'Connor and a few more guys. So there's a lot of experience on both teams, and I don't think there's going to be a lot between the two teams. Both teams play a similar type of game. Both teams are fairly physical, and they won't be playing extra defenders or playing any of that sort of thing. So I think it's going to be a very entertaining final.
You know, before the semi-finals were on, I was tipping that maybe Boar and even indeed Belmont to a lesser extent might get over the line, but St. Rynagh, like KK yesterday, really managed the game well in the last 15 minutes, because, you know, Belmont maybe weren't as close to KK for large periods yesterday, but Boar led for a long time throughout in this game.
Yeah, Boar definitely, yeah. And like, it took a lot for St. Rynagh's. They just held their time. They didn't panic. They didn't get excited. They knew what they had to do. And that's a great sign of a team. You know, even though early on in the game they knew they weren't playing the way, but that was mainly due to Boar as well. Like I've seen Boar playing Clarine, and I've seen them playing Coolerie. And like, Boar are a lively outfit, and there's lots of good young hurlers. And I'm sure their day will come as well. You know, they probably need to learn from this, and they'll be very disappointed going home tonight. But it was to be St. Rynagh's day, and they've used all their skills. But when you look at the likes of Dermot Horn coming in off the line there, and, you know, they have other players coming in, and they have a very strong panel. Their panel is very strong, and they have loads of options there.
You mentioned, you know, a lot of young players that have loads of days ahead of them, but maybe a word to particularly the most experienced man out there, Brian Mullins, who served Boar so well. Be no surprise if he comes back next year, but if that's to be his final campaign for Boar hurling, I think since 1996 at senior level for the club, incredible servant to Boar.
Oh, Brian Mullins owes nothing to Boar or Offaly, and I hurled against him all those years ago, 20 plus years ago, and it's credit to the guy that he's still togging out for Boar. And look, he never lets Boar down. He's a solid, steadying influence on the defence, and has been for all those years. And I think if whatever his decision is, Brian Mullins is legendary in Boar.
You know, Ken Hogan, since he came in to St. Rynagh's last year, they'd been to a few finals, beaten in a few finals up and down. Ken Hogan, a lot of success, particularly with Offaly club teams. He's really started to steady that ship with St. Rynagh's. They've won one. They're in the final now in 2 weeks' time. And Joey O'Connor, who a lot was spoken about with his suspension, was out. He comes back and adds a lot of experience and pace to that Rynagh's midfield.
Yeah, like, Ken Hogan's around a long time, and he's a very experienced manager, and he's gone back years and years of managing clubs and county under 21 teams in Tipperary and different things. So, you know, he'll leave no stone unturned, and that's very important coming into a final. And you can see with Rynagh, they're playing a very disciplined game of hurling as well, and they know what they're about, they know how they want to play the game, and they're playing straight lines. You know, they're not going across the field or going backwards, and when they get the ball, they're letting it into where it's going to hurt. And I'd expect Ken will have his homework done on KK for the final.
Lastly, on the final itself, Kilcormac Killoughey and St. Rynagh's, two hugely experienced teams the last 15 years or so. Kilcormac Killoughey with more titles, they have four to St. Rynagh's two in that period. What do you expect in the final? You know, both teams, as we said, carry that experience. They know how to handle these games. The pressure won't get to them. Kilcormac Killoughey, they have a lot of the older group still there, a lot of success in that group, but they've introduced the likes of, you know, Lachlan Kavanagh, Cahill Kiley, and they've started to slowly step up and maybe turn the guard a bit towards Kilcormac Killoughey.
Yeah, look, I'd expect KK have nothing to lose. You know, they can throw caution to the wind in this final. I think Rynagh's will be the slight favourites and that, but everything's there to play for KK. And, you know, when you look back at Rynagh, you'd nearly assume they'd have more than two titles won. They seem to be around for so long, but they've lost a good number of finals as well before they got to win. So, you know, they'll be a bit edgy as well. And finals are hard won. When you get into a final, they're difficult to win. And, like, it's whichever team on the day shows up. And you have to go and express yourself and want to show what you're capable of doing. And I just have Ryan as a slight favourites, but I wouldn't rule out KK because simple reason, as you said, they have four championships in the bag. They have a lot of new guys in. Even all their young guys are coming in. They've won underage titles. They're not, you know, KK are a great club for producing good underage squads, and they're constantly winning these titles, and that's good for confidence as well. So they won't be in any way overawed by the occasion, even though they'll possibly have five or six new guys. But it's what they have on the bench that could swing it their way as well. So I think it's going to be a very close affair.
So that was the last word by Johnny Dooley. We do know the county final pairing is Kilcormac versus St. Rynagh is a hugely anticipated final, and we'll bring you more in the coming week.